Cord tape add-on. I thought I'd add a few details. Most of them are in the vlog I locked up since that seemed to be bothering people. And it's all in sequence. But just a couple of little details in the cord tapes. The first one was the ultimatum. We had already been married a year. I gave him another year to move in. So meanwhile, we're dating. I said I didn't get married to get date to keep dating. He's taking me on the OCD tour, I call it, the every other weekend and Wednesday nights out. But he's telling everybody something else, using it as an excuse for the reason why he's not moving in. I don't know any of this is going on. I just know I've had enough. So at the end of year two, he doesn't move in, and I break it off. That's it. We can't do this anymore. It's just crazy. It's making me so crazy. And I don't know what's going on around me, but I just want to get back to some kind of normal because this is not normal, right? So I tell him, go ahead, divorce me. Yeah, that's another thing he threatens all the time. He threatens. And I said, I'm not paying for a divorce. This is ridiculous. You go ahead. You keep wanting the divorce. You pay for it. I'll see you in court. I do whatever you want. So I cut him off, no contact. So about 3 to 4 months later, I meet my friend, and the reason he knew my friend and I broke up was because of the flying monkeys. One, yeah, the two neighbors, they were keeping an eye on me, right? Spying on me, basically, and reporting back to him because he was so concerned about me, right? The second thing that happened was after we got back together, he lets it slip, and this is how sick this is, that his lawyer is tracking me by my social security number. That's how he knew me and my friend broke up. Because I would fly back and forth to see my friend, and his lawyer's reporting back to him my every move based on my social security number. That was 15 years ago. That's how involved his lawyer was then. I remember looking at him when he let this slip because he was rather proud of it. And I'm like, is that even legal? But we're already back together, and the persona, the guy I married, thought I married, shows up, and I just let it go. I'm like, okay, that was weird, but I remembered it. Also, the motion for financial relief, I actually put a paragraph in there saying I already had CPTSD in detail so that I was hoping if there were drama or to avoid drama that the judge would see, hey, she's already got this, guys. Ease up. Did they? No. It was slippery all the way, slimy actually. How they got out of stuff. Yeah. And then trial. He was going to go to trial. But at this stage in the game, another $10,000 was too much money. Had it been 10 years ago, he probably would have gone for it. Public humiliation is his thing when it comes to me. So he really was chomping at the bit to go to trial, but it was just going to cost too much money right now. So that was another reason we settled, but I'm sure he was ready to go. Yeah. End of add-on.